Hi, I'm Henry. If you found this video, it's because you're looking to wire up a kill switch to your car, and I expect you're looking for the easiest method of how to do so. So, in short, I will show you how to wire up a kill switch to your fuel pump. Not necessarily the wrong way, however, not the best way, because that's the only way I know at the moment, and I will show you the problem with doing that, and you can choose whether you follow that route or not. What you will need to do is cut into the fuel pump cable, and then you will wire one side of this cable to your button cable, and then the same with the other. And then with the button or the switch, hide this very creatively in your car somewhere. Obviously, because it's a switch, you will need to operate it, so it needs to be convenient enough for yourself to put into place every time you get out of your car. And it also needs to be inconvenient enough that a thief won't find it in 5 seconds. Over the course of a few more videos, I am looking to explore how to install a somewhat more safer method that won't leave me in the predicament that I could have been in with the previous kill switch that I've had. Now, of course, I won't go into the specifics of installing this kill switch because of the risk of thieves watching this video. However, I don't feel any of this content is giving the game away, given that a good criminal probably knows exactly how to bypass a kill switch in your car using various methods. This isn't model specific, however, access to your fuel pump is normally from underneath the rear bench or occasionally from the boot, depending on what kind of car you have, and you can identify it from this panel. So this is what a fuel pump cover typically looks like. In my case, it's underneath the rear bench, and I will insert a picture here. And then those cables come up through into the body and follows the loom and connects into the loom underneath that panel. To identify the wire you want to cut into, the proper way to identify this would be through your user manual. However, typically it will be one of the thicker gauge wires. This is the problem with wiring directly to your fuel pump. A fuel pump, once in operation, is drawing a certain amount of volts. You must ensure that you have the correct gauge wire and switch that can handle that current being drawn consistently. Otherwise, the result can be burny. I'm not able to explain how many currents are drawn through a fuel pump at any given time. However, I believe it's something to do with 13 volts when in operation, and it will draw up to 60 amps at any given time. I'm not entirely too sure. So these are what you will need to make your kill switch. You will need a rocker switch similar to this that can facilitate 25 to 30 amps running continuously through it. When it comes to choosing the correct gauge cable, I would suggest it's common practice to look what you're splicing into and don't choose anything thinner than what you're cutting into. When it comes to choosing the correct cable, there are many calculations that go into it: the length of the cable, how many currents are drawn, how many are lost over the length, and many other factors. Something that works for me is to match the gauge of the cable that you're splicing into. For example, if you're splicing into something thick, don't then use speaker wire to join on, otherwise you will have an issue like I did with my kill switch. Just because it's fun. This is what happens when you put too much current through your cable. My one and only tip when installing this kill switch is to blend your wires into the loom and make it look like the factory loom. So this is why I'm making this video, because that is a okay method, but it's not necessarily the best way to do it. That said, I still believe a kill switch is a good method of security for your car. For example, an opportunist thief who has your keys somehow might start the car, it won't turn over, and once they've had a quick fiddle around with things, they'll leave. In that instance, then I believe a kill switch is an optimal security and very cost effective. The better approach to installing a kill switch would be to go between the relay for the fuel pump and the ECU, and instead clip the signal wire, which draws a much lower current, and lessens the risk of any overheating or any issues with the fuel supply when pulling out of a junction. So in the next video, I would like to explore that more and see if we can do anything here and get access behind this fuse box. If you can help me in the comments section, please do. If you like this content and want to keep up to date, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the like button.